First of all, let me wish you happy Dasara. Let me give you the background, few of the backgrounds in last 2-3 months what has happened. Honorable Prime Minister actually directed the DFS, the Department of Financial Services, to have a discussion from the grassroots level. So all the banks, you must be aware that you had a different structure of the discussion. First at the district level where the all the branches came and they had an ideation. A lot of good suggestion came from the branches. The idea was that the idea doesn't germinate the top, it also comes from the bottom also. The first phase, it was all the branch managers, assistant branch managers, they participated and gave a lot of valuable ideas. The second phase was at the state level with the interbank. Lot of general managers, regional general managers came, EDs participated, and lot of good ideas were again synthesized. I think is better. Synthesized and those things are compiled. In that, one thing we came to know, that is that there is a lot of enthusiasm at the grassroots level. It needs to be channelized. So that was put before the Honorable Finance Minister. The next phase of that is the national level ideation process is in pipeline, where the Honorable Prime Minister will be available. He will be there to listen to all the bankers, how to improve the banking transaction, how to improve the credit facilities, how to improve the credit culture. Because as you know, that lot of cleaning has happened in last 2-3 years. Lot of NPAs which were there, now the provisioning has been made. Systems has been put in place in the banks. Prudential norms has been put in place in the banks. Banks have been sensitized. Customers have been sensitized. So they know that what we need to do, we need to do a good banking. What the customer know, we have to take a good, they have to do the good borrowing so that the culture of credit culture should encourage. Recently, you must be seeing that a lot of hue and cry has been made in the media about this liquidity issue. There is a liquidity crunch in the market. People are not getting the money. Let me tell you that every day we receive a report how much cash is available in the public. There is no currency, there is no liquidity crunch. So with that in idea, last month, when there was an annual review meeting of all the banks, public sector banks, with the Honorable Finance Minister, this topic was one of the issue which was discussed at length. All the CMDs and EDs, those who have participated, including few of the general managers also were invited. They spoke in one language. There is no issue of liquidity crunch in the market. We are all there. We are all there to lend the helping hand to the NBFCs, to the HFCs, to the microfinance institution, to the customers. So what is being spread in the media is something, a story. With that, they suggested, all the CMD suggested, okay, let us celebrate the festival by telling that we are with you to celebrate the festival. That's why the tagline, Tewaharo ke sang, Man mein hum, Banko ke sang. That was also designed and given by them only. So this is totally the initiative of all the public sector banks, private sector banks and other financial institutions. They are participating in a very big way all over across the countries. All put together, this will be done in two phases. Phase one, 250 districts have been identified. And next phase, just before the Deepavali, 21st to 25th, another 200 districts will be covered. So 450 districts will be covered all across the India. Just to keep the momentum, bring the momentum to the credit facilities further. It will not be restricted to 450 districts, because taking the clue from this outreach program, other districts also will be encouraged to participate, will be encouraged to take advantage of the festivity season. And a lot of, after that what has happened, then Honorable Finance Minister requested that please organize a meeting with the private sector banks, mutual funds, microfinance units, NBFC, HFCs. Let me hear their views. So all private sector banks came, so 10, 15 days back. Leading NBFC came, housing finance company came. They all spoke in one language. There is a growth in the home loan, there is a growth in the vehicle, there is a growth in the personal loan, ranging from 15% to 32%, depend on the bank. So there is no liquidity crunch in the market, what has been actually publicized by the press media, that something is a great calamity is in place. It's not like that. After that, again it was decided that let all the private sector bank also should participate in the outreach program. So whole thing was again chalked out, and it has been planned in a very meticulous way. Like few of the banks, if you don't have a reach in a particular districts, they have also been assigned that particular district to see to it that they can enlarge their market. Like Bank of India presence is not there. They have been given opportunity so that they can understand that I can also enlarge the market in Andhra Pradesh, in Hyderabad. Few of the banks where their presence is more dominant, they have been taken out from that place, given a place where their place is not dominant, so that they see the area, the fertile ground where they can actually go and expand. Along with that, your financial inclusion schemes are also being targeted, like you must be seeing the installs for PM, the Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, opening of the bank account, Aadhaar enrollment. So on the whole, it is a very comprehensive and very combined program for increasing the credit culture, increasing the advances for these small loans, which actually boost the economy. Like the people start buying the car, taking the loan, the automobile industry will get boost. If you take a consumer loan, buy a TV, then the TV industry will get a boost. So this is a interconnected effect will happen, and I am sure by this Deepavali, first phase, second phase, when the result will be out, will be actually shining in a flying colors. And by the end of the festivity season, when the Christmas is there, by the New Year's, we'll have more numbers to show that. And we have to show to the market, we have to show to the society that what has been flagged, that there is a liquidity crunch, was actually a figure of imagination. This was not the actual story. Actual story is here. So every day, whatever you are doing, the data is being compiled. Yesterday's figure, yesterday's all the activities, photographs, has been given to the Honorable Finance Minister by 10 o'clock. And she is aware about that. For this outreach program, Honorable Finance Minister also desired, and it has been communicated, the responsibility has been given to the Honorable Emerge Finance, to invite the local MPs, ministers, union ministers, so that they can go, they can actually see that what is happening, so that they can also spread among the mass to what is being actually told is a simple story, but the reality is something else. And with this, so seeing the participation, I'm sure this 2-3 days participation, what is there, each Mela will have a 2-3 days of the Mela. At the end of it, we'll have a very good result. The other than whatever the banks, they have participated here, if you have the branches in the other district, please collect the data from them also, because your momentum here, what you have given the momentum here, that is also getting translated to the other branches also, those who have not participated. So take the clue of all the data you gather and see to it that each one of you come with a very flying colors and negate the story in the market which is being spread that the liquidity crunch is there. The second aspect is that all the public sector banks, they have floated a company called PSB Online 59 Minutes. Last 2nd November it was actually been live, for which the Honorable Prime Minister also talked about. The MSME was the first loan segment which was targeted. It's fully automatic. Customer has to just fill the form, put the GSTN number, ITR returns for 3 years, 6 months of your bank statement. The computer program automatically calculates how much loan you are eligible, at what interest, and gives you the name of the banks. To these banks you can go. You can select the banks, your application is forwarded to the banks automatically, and the policy has been changed. Once there is a PSBO line, in principle sanction is there, and it is given in 59 minutes, not even 60 minutes. So immediately you have to take into account and sanction the loan. A lot of good work has been done in that case. Now government decided, requested the bank, why not put this personal loan also, what we are seeing, that home loan, vehicle loan, education loan, your home loan should also be on the PSB online. I am happy to inform that except vehicle loan, all the loan products what we are seeing are also on the PSB online. By tomorrow, 90% of the public sector banks, they will make the vehicle loan also live on the PSB online. Few of the banks, they will do on 10th. By 10th, all your segments what you are seeing, they will be online at the PSB online. Customers can reach to that website, because Hyderabad is an IT hub, so you can take the help of that PSB online. You can apply the loan. It's fully automated. No human intervention is there. You get the loan sanction and the PSB banks, they disperse. And this is not only the PSB banks, private sector banks have also joined the PSB online. And within 3-4 months of the launch, this has become the biggest lending platform in India. That's what has been reported by the Credit Suisse. This has surpassed your Paisa Bazaar and all those loans, online portal is there. It has become much more bigger than that. So this, we should also use this opportunity. I request all the private sector banks, public sector banks, to make this PSB online a grand success. With that, it is easy for you to actually entertain the customers. The customer need not go to your branch. With your manpower, you can actually concentrate on some other areas. And this automated process actually eases your processing also. At the same time, it enhances the ease of living for all the customers. So these are the things which I thought I must share with you. I wish all the grand success and wish you all the best. Wish you a good wishes for all the festivals which are coming, which are on the way. Thank you.